No, no te son. Okay, so watch party. Shorting showcase. Watch party. And special event. No, fuck. Final Fantasy 14 online. Okay. Pam 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 pam. Oh yeah, I forgot. So I'm gonna make you group. Minutes temporal. And now here, add image. Okay, browse. And downloads and this. Bingo! Okay. I'm gonna lower this. Not lower. And I got this part. Maybe on the corner, I guess. Either this corner. Maybe this corner? It's starting!
I don't know.
Oh, okay.
The moon?
Oh, it is the moon. What the fuck? What's happening?
Wait, this is 7.0? Yeah, this is 6.0. Yoshi lied to me. I was expecting
7.0. Yeah, Yoshi lied to us. The moon!
The final days were upon us. Fabric of the star had begun to fray, its lands rent by tooth and claw.
Okay, yep.
Holy fucking shit, dude. What are those?
Level. All right, I'm playing him.
What the fuck is that?
What
is that? What is that?
No, he healed. What?
New healer? It's not alchemist?
Okay with this.
Are you okay? Okay, so we get a new driver. I'm doing the bingo, yeah. Let me know if you want it. I'm doing the bingo, let me know if you want it.
I just want to know where they are right now.
They just are.
Past the far edge of fate.
Aliens?
Hey, our friend.
Tolling the coming of the end.
Dude! Forspoken. Endwalker. Huh.
Yes, okay. As expected, that's fine.
When does fall start? Like August? September?
September. Because September, October, November.
Oh, okay, yeah. Yoshida, my boy!
Yasan, konnichiwa! Final Fantasy XIV producer兼 director の Yoshida です。Hi guys! My name is Naoki Yoshida, producer and director of Final Fantasy XIV. Bonjour à tous et enchanté!
Alright,
what the fuck? Is that flex?
Final Fantasy XIV. Guten Tag to the man of giving Naoki Yoshida, producer and director.From Final Fantasy XIV というわけで、4言語で挨拶してみました。よろしくお願いします。ちょっとね、今日会場にね、観客いないので
It's just fucking no comment
全部言うつもりか。 Twitch も YouTube もコメント返してもらってるんで、すごいたくさんいる、ありがとうございます。じゃあ早速新情報発表会、お届けしようと思うんですが、グローバル対応なので僕一人ではとてもじゃないけどさばききれないので、今日僕のね、心強いトランスレーター呼びたいと思います。
OK, we don't have
translator. コージフォックスでーす。
Justin, you missed the, you missed the trailer.
No, I saw the trailer.
Oh, okay.
よろしくね。
Hello everyone, on behalf of our producer and director Naoki Yoshida, I'd like to welcome you all to the announcement showcase for everyone here and watching around the world. My name is Michael Christopher Koji Fox, and today I will be Yoshi P's English voice.
English voice.
Yeah, I'm pretty good at English, just kind of.
So many comments.
They're going too fast. I can't see.
いやー、すごいね。ありがとうございます。ありがとうございます。
Yes, thank you very much.
まあ、例年だと、まあ、今回新情報発表会っていうのをね、わざわざやるのは、やっぱりこう、世界中でどうしてもね、広がってしまっている新型コロナウイルスの対応ということで、なかなか、ファイナルファンタジー14、ファンフェスバル必ず大規模に世界中でやってるんですけど、まあ、それができてないと。
It's related to her.
So usually around this time of the year, even earlier,
that's a really nice dragon shirt.
Final Fantasy fan festival.
I want that dragon shirt. Yeah,
yeah, that's really nice.
Because of the pandemic, that is limited us.
世界中の医療関係者の方が我々の生活のために戦ってくれている中、まあ、やっぱりどうしてもこう僕らもね、世界に打って出て、まあ、アナウンスするっていうのが難しい状況の中で、今回は日本で映画館を借りてですね、皆さんにファイナルファンタジー14の最新情報、これからの未来をお届けしていこうと思います。
Because there are people around the world putting out their most to fight this pandemic and make sure that it doesn't spread any further. We've decided to hold this announcement showcase here in a theater in Japan to do our part.
Yes, I did.
パッチ 5.2 から 5.3 の間に
1ヶ月
半から3ヶ月、スケジュールの、ね、開発もやっぱり止まってしまうっていう状況があって、どうしても今日発表させていただいた次なるファイナルファンタジー14の拡張エンドウォーカーっていうのもやっぱりちょっと時期がずれていってしまってます。
As you remember, back around during, right around the development between patch 5.2 and 5.3, because of the pandemic, we had to slow down our development for about 2.5 to 3 months. And because of that, that has affected the release date of Endwalker.
ですので今日はですね、ファンフェスティバルの基調講演1回目プラスアルファぐらいで、聞いていただければ、この先ね、デジタルファンフェスもあります。今回とそのデジタルファンフェスと2回に分けて、この最新拡張エンドウォーカー行月のフィナーレのお話をしていこうと思います。
So today we'd like you to treat this announcement showcase as our first big fan festival, like the keynote announcement that we have at our first fan festival. And then of course, later in the year we're going to have our digital fan festival, and there we'll be releasing even more information.
はい、というわけで今日は可能な限り、新情報をお届けしていきたいと思います。
Alright, and so today we're going to try to tell you as much as we can.
さあ、 まずはですね、
トレーラー
先ほどご覧いただきました。まだまだティザートレーラーではありますが、世界の、ね、週末を思わせるような、惨状が巻き起こっていました。
So you just saw our first teaser trailer, and even though it was a teaser, it was filled with lots of exciting information about Endwalkers and the second coming of the final days.
どうやらね、暁の面々はそれに、光の戦士もそうですけど、対抗しているような様子が描かれてましたね。
And we saw how the Warrior of Light and members of the Scions were again battling against the coming of the final days and for trying to prevent it.
というわけで、こちら、Final Fantasy XIV 6.0 Endwalker 行月のフィナーレと読みます。今年2021年秋を目指して開発を進めております
。Balin, right? Looks like Balin. I mean, it has a shield.
Our newest expansion.6.0 Endwalker
That's newest class.
slated for release in fall of 2021.
そういえば、コージ、ファイナルファンタジー14 9.0 からね、ずっとスタッフとして参加してくれてるよね。
Right, yeah, I've been around since 1.0. So.
今日実際この放送を見てくださってる方にも多分ね 1.0 からやってくださ
ってる方がいると思います。
Okay, fine. What are you trying to hint at here?
Since 1.0.
コメントを見るといるのかな。おお、すごいたくさんいらっしゃいますね。ありがとうございます。あのこのアートワークですね、実は 1.0 の時に似たような構図のアートワークがございます。若き日のね、光の戦士なのかな。
If you recall, there is a similar type of artwork that we had back from 1.0, back whenThe Warrior of Light was a lot younger, but doing a similar type of pose.
はい、ぜひね、ちょっと見比べていただくのも意図的にね、ちょっとその成長というかね、奇跡を照らし合わせてみたので、そういったところもね、見ていただけると嬉しいかなと思います。
We'd like players to take a look at this and remember back to that 1.0 Warrior of Light and see how he has moved forward and see how he has developed over the years.
まあ僕もね、年取りましたね。
Yeah, we've also come along in years as well.
というわけで今回、このなんだろうプロモーションでね頑張っているこう光の戦士、今回は主役ナイトジョブに、
光の戦士
して活躍してくれそうです。
So as you can see here, our Warrior of Light, he will be fighting this expansion as a paladin.
さて。では早速中身について触れていこうと思うんですが、こういうタイミングいつも僕ストーリーのお話からするんですけど。
Okay, so now we want to get into a little bit more of the content of Endwalker. And usually at this point in the keynote, we'll start talking about the story.
Fucker.
さっきね、トレーラーの中に気になるシーンがあったと思うので、最初はこちらの情報から今回行こうかなと思います。
But as you saw in the trailer, there is something that was very important, and we want to touch upon that
Everything was
before
important.
we get into the story.
New charge.
Give me, give me.
Two DPS.
Two tanks.
2つなんですけど、このエンドウォーカーで2つのジョブを実装させていただこうと思います。
So for Endwalker, we are planning the release of multiple jobs.
Dark Paladin.
Two new jobs.
前回の思い出すですね、ファンフェスでこうジョブを発表していた時にです
ね、There's a lot of jobs. I would expect to be just one.
世界中のプレイヤーの方から言われまして。
So it passed Fan Festival when we announced the new jobs. We had a lot of feedback from players all around the world saying that we didn't have enough healers and we needed new.
Okay, yeah, that was expected.
今回は先に今回実装する2つの新しいジョブのロールをお伝えしてしまおうと思います。
So before we get into which new jobs are going to be releasing, we want to tell you at least whichroles those two jobs
healer and caster.
はい、もちろん一つは、
yeah,
世界中からご要望いただいたヒーラーを新たなジョブとして、一つ実装させていただきつつ、もう一つは近接物理 DPS を実装する予定です。
And so the first role will be healer.
And yeah, that was
what the fuck?
Melee DPS.
Melee DPS.
Please. その見てたんですけど。なぜかですね、ビクシーが実装されるんじゃないかっていう予想が結構見えてて、どっからその予想が出てきたのかすごい不思議なんですけど。
So we've been checking out, you know, the how what people have been speculating the new job to be. And the guesses have been kind of off for the most part.
No apothecary.
I mean, it's a healer, so it can be alchemist, which is similar.
We're not talking about any.
No, they're not going to call it chemist or alchemist because it's
just. Oh, yeah. You're right.
Or apothecary.
Something different.
今回トレーラーに登場していた、アルフィノ、彼がまさに新ジョブへとジョブチェンジしております。
So,
Alfino's gonna change jobs.
As you saw in the trailer, it is Alfino that has changed into that new job specific to
anyone. Is he the healer?
I think it's a healer. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
ジョブのうち一つ、
a healer with floating blades.
についてご紹介していこうと思います。
So today,
I'm down. That looks fucking cool.
Showcase, we'll be revealing
Fuck
one
my fairy.
Of the new
Give me a chat.
The healer job.
では早速ではありますが、その新ヒーラージョブの、動画をご用意してありますのでご覧いただきましょう。
And so, rather than explaining it, we'd first like you to show you a video
yes,
of that
yes,
healer
yes.
job in action. Here we go.
I'm. The fight is the music.
Oh no.
Oh dude. Oh, oh.
Everyone's.
Gun?
They're like floating guns、
What's、
or something.
What's that? It's like a buffer. It looks like a buffer.
They're aetherite.
Oh!
And shield. AoE.
Oh, dude! That's so flashy, dude. What the hell?
It's just gonna be.
Oh!
Oh, Sage.
今回ですね、行月のフィナーレ、新ジョブ第1弾は、魔力を込めた武器を、賢者というジョブ名になっております。
So, the first new job for Endwalker is Sage, sporting a unique ether-imbued weapon.
Can you say
ちょっとね、CG でもご紹介して。
Is that the direct translation of Sage?
I think, yeah.
We have some CG and some parts that we'd like to show you.
Dude, that looks sick as fuck. I would have thought it was a DPS, not gonna lie.
It's just gonna be Astrologian 2.0.
So, very Astrologian, gotcha. Might as well just stop playing the class.
So, why did Alf, you know, happen to take up this new profession?You have to play through the main story of 6.0 to find out.
はい。では、賢者のその特徴
を。I wonder what the DPS gonna be.
ご紹介していこうと思います。
So now we'd like to give you a simple rundown of how the job actually
works. Oh, nice.
まず、賢者の特徴、まあ一つ目、まあヒーラー。先ほどね、お伝えしましたロールはヒーラーとなります。
So as we mentioned before, the role is going to be a healer.
白魔導士、学者。それから先制術師に続く第4のヒーラーとして、今回賢者が追加となります。
And so Sage will be our fourth healer behind White Mage, Scholar, and Astrologian.
そしてですね、武器は剣具という14オリジナルになりますね、武器を使います。
How we had a class like this
in
Final Fantasy?
The main arm for the Sage is going to be a Final Fantasy.14 original called the new
list. Final Fantasy 14 original.
まあ魔力でこれを操作するっていう感じなんですけど、あの後ろにある4つのあの武器、あれがグラフィックス変わっていろんな武器になっていくというふうに思ってください。
And so this weapon is controlled by the ether by the magic that the player has. And as you see, those four items back there, that is the weapon. The visuals of those will change depending on what type of weapon is equipped.
What?
そしてですね、当然クラスの方は選んでございません。ジョブからになりました。
I don't know why they had to say that.
And as has been the case,
that threw me off for a second.
Required class, and you will start directly from the Sage job.
初期レベルに関しては70から予定しております。
Yeah,
and the starting level is planned to be 7.
いずれかのですね、ジョブがレベル70に到達していて、この行月のフィナーレ、エンドウォーカーの、拡張権利がついていれば、すぐにでもね、始められるようになってます。
And so there are two conditions for playing the Sage. One is that you have at least one job, one other job that is level 70 or above, as well as you have purchased the Endwalker expansion.
さあ、ではバトルイメージの方も、簡単にご紹介していこうと思います。
So let's take a look a little bit, take a look at the battle style of the Sage.
バトルイメージ、
今回実装となる賢者セージはバリアヒーラーという役割になっております。
So we look at the sage as a barrier type healer.
What kind of barrier
style? 今までバリアヒーラーというのはですね、まあ学者、まあ白魔同士がねピュアヒーラーと呼ばれていて、学者バリアだったよね。で今回なるほど。じゃあ賢者はバリアヒーラーとして実装されるのね。あ、え、じゃあ先制術師はってなると思うんですけど。
Okay, so as you know, we have our white mage, which is can be considered a pure healer, and then we have our scholar, which is more of a barrier healer. And so if this time the sage is also going to be a barrier healer, then what's going to happen with astrologian?
ヒーラーはですね、今回 6.0 から、ピュアヒーラーに乗る。それからバリアヒーラーにジョブという明確に区分したバランスで取っていこうと思っていて、先制術師を完全にピュアヒーラー寄りに回収していきます。こちらについてはですね、後日また詳しくどう変わっていくのかお伝えしようと思ってますが、ロールとしてはヒーラーの中でもピュアヒーラーとバリアヒーラーが分かれていくというふうに思ってください。
So, starting in 6.0, we are planning to make a clear distinction between pure healers and barrier healers. We want to have two pure healers and two barrier healers. And so, with 6.0, we plan on performing some retooling of the astrologian job to make
maybe
the astrologian job
more interesting. Maybe instead of shield, you're going to have like regen or more potent heals, I guess, or buffing.
I just hope they remove the seals and bring back the card system.
Yeah.
And this will extend to our matching in the raid
what?
Finders to make a distinction between barrier healers.
When they're reworking Astro.
But they're saying they're making a distinction in raid finders, so it's not just going to be healer, it's going to be like type of healer.
Oh!
早すぎて
分
からない。
It's going too fast, we can't tell what's going on.
はい。そしてですね、武器に関しては魔法によって剣具という武器を操っていろんな回復だったりですね、攻撃だったりバリアを張ったりということをやっていきます。
And as we mentioned before, the sage will use ether to manipulate their weapon, the Nullis, in combat, whether that be for healing, whether that be for attacking, whether that be for putting up barriers.
それからですね、まあこれ、Final Fantasy XIV は各ジョブでゲーム体験を変えていくっていうところをコンセプトにしてるんですけど、賢者の場合は一時的に、自分の魔法を強化していくっていう新しいそのプレイ感っていうのを目指して開発を進めています。
And because we try to make our jobs unique from the other jobs to give a different kind of experience for each job, we're trying something here with the Sage where they're able to temporarily augment their own magic abilities to make them more powerful.
They have a stance?
まあ、攻撃隊っていうところもあったりして、いろいろまたこれまでのヒーラーとは全然異なる体験をお届けしようと思ってますので、
they get cleric stance and no one else?
ぜひお楽しみにお待ちいただければと思います。
We believe the experience that we will be providing with the Sage will be completely unique and a lot of fun. Please look forward.
It looks
up. There's a shot.
そしてですね、ジョブクエスト、この賢者になるためのジョブクエストに関しては、リムサロミンサから開始予定です。ですので、今月のフィナーレ、エンドウォーカーがリリースされてすぐ、ジョブクエストを開放して、新しいジョブで、ね、冒険を進めていくことも可能になります。
And so this job quest...for the Sage will be offered in Limsalaminsa. So if you want to play the new 6.0 main scenario as the Sage, you will be able to do that.
もうね、さっきからですね、僕コメントをね、
watch the job trailer to see which one I want to play.
なんかね、ガンダムとかファンネルっていう単語が出てるんですよ。
So you're looking at the comments and you see lots of things that are mentioning kind of Gundam, that the new list are kind of Gundam-like.
What?
よくわかんない。それに関してはね、まあここに書かれてると、まあノーコメントとさせていただきたい。
No comment.
剣具です。お忘れなく、剣具という武器です。
New list. It's completely original.
はい。ではですね、 これらを踏まえて、ちょっとイメージついたと思うので、それを踏まえてですね、もう一回動画をご覧いただこうかなと思っております。
Alright, so with all of this in mind, let's have one more look、at what the Sage can do in that showcase video again.
Play
the video.
Do you want to show you again then?
And wouldn't be a...
Wait, are they showing the trailer or are you guys like stuck? Okay, there we go.
They're playing it now.
Yeah, it was
stuck. It's so fucking flashy. I can't. The guy he does now is fucking cool. The next one, this one. That was fucking nice. That's a nice class.
Alright, and so that was the job showcase video.
まあなんかちょっとおしゃれでスタイリッシュですよね。
It's a very stylish job, you could say. Wait. Yoshipi?
Hey?
What's he wearing now?
Atsukatta.
You were hot.
What does it say?
Uh-huh. And anything else?
Nani?
Something else?
Neighborhood?
No comment.
I'll be here if you need me.
Okay.
さあ。まあ、
Spider-Man.
新しいジョブのね、賢者。
Resident Evil.
ご期待していただきたいんですけど、
What does it mean?
するよって言ってる近接で、ディベースに関しては、また、次のですね、デジタルファンフェスティバルの方でお届けしていこうかなと思っております。なんかコメントがね、すごいザワザワしてるんですよね。
So, we'd like you to please look forward to this new, Sage job. Okay.Concerning the second job that we have planned for release in Endwalker, we will be revealing that in May at the Digital
Festival.
Dark Knight? People are guessing that the second job is Dark Knight?
You already did it? No, not showing fucking me.
Necromancer?
Yeah, it's gotta be Necromancer.
Do you think it's not really correct?
His shirt starts with.
Well, yeah, yes. Yeah.
さらなる新ジョブに関してはまた後日お届けします。
He's got like a death shirt on.
力士は忘れてほしい。
ネクロマンサー、リーパー、シニガミ。
さあ、
リーパー would be a nice one。
続いて、じゃあ、
With a scythe?
Oof!
Oof!
Flannel, I guess I'll have to be both a healer and a DPS. if they have a scythe, it's game over. I have to play
the scythe.
その前にですね、ちょっとタイトルにご注目いただきたい。
Okay, to start, I'd like to draw your attention to our title.
Final Fantasy 14.
Okay, Final Fantasy 14.
Endwalker.
Endwalker.
行月のフィナーレ?
Translate this, this is the Dawn Moon Finale.
What?
Final, End, Finale.
Final, End, Finale. I sense a pattern.
What?
意地でも終わるのかみたいな。
It's just gonna, it's gonna end.
There's no way this is a lot of expansion.
このキーワードが示すのはメインストーリーの大きなサーガとして
He's already said that it's the end of like the Zodiac Arc.
The Zodiac Arc, yeah, yeah.
Final Fantasy 14, you, I'm
brave.
If
you see a new healer.
今月のフィナーレで完結を迎えます。
So final, end, and finale. These are all keywords that allude to the ending of this 10-year
like
saga of Hydaelyn and Zodiac.
こちらですね、まあ、キューフォーティンから続けてきて、僕が担当になってですね、2013年に、
Such because of Astrologian.
リリースさせていただきました。
If you look back at, the, at my history, with Final Fantasy, all began in 2013 with A Realm Reborn.
まあこちら、神聖の朝。
So you look at this as、a new morning.
そして、拡張パッケージ第1弾、ヘブンズワード、蒼天の石ガールドは、
Wait. Do the colors actually go through?
And so then we move on to our first large expansion, Heaven's Word, which represented that
clear
sky that you have.
If he's so much,
and then noon, and then twilight, and then
sunset.
Okay.
And then that's so fucking smart, dude.
Second expansion, the Warrior of Light headed east.
Stormblood, Guren no Higure.
And in Stormblood, we came upon a crimson twilight.
そして世界中で非常にご好評の声をいただいた、前回の拡張パッケージ、シャドーブリンガーズ、漆黒の夜となっております。
And then finally, our most recent expansion, that was praised around the world by fans, we have Shadowbringers and the Black of Night.
そして今回、次なる拡張パッケージ、エンドウォーカーによって、まあ、惑星ハイデリン、命を巡る物語と。
Planet with a hole in it?
No, that's a moon, isn't it? That's a moon.
It has a giant hole in it.
And
that's
moon
with a
hole. We've come full circle in the tale of Life and Heidelin.
It's got a spaceship stick flying.
これまでの拡張パッケージちょっと注意していただきたいんですけど、例えばですが、今回前回のシャドーブリンガーズ、今パッチ 5.4 が来てます。
They were, yeah, the logos were showing like morning, dawn, the chill like that. It's like it goes through a day cycle.
Oh, they big brained it.
Yeah, they were too smart. They had too much power.
So normally with our expansions, as you know, we don't end the story.
It's the end of the
Heidelin
zone. Yes.
While in 5.0, for example, we did get that end credits at the end of 5.0, the story wasn't actually finished until 5.3.
The amount of people that are saying, oh, it's the end of the game.
Yeah. その内容で全てきれいに完結させるつもりです。
Everything is done at the
end.
However, with Endwalker and 6.0, we plan on having the story complete itself by the end of the actual expansion 6.0.
ただですね、ちょっとコメントもすごいザーザーしてるんですけど、これでですね、もちろんファイナルファンタジー14が終わってしまうわけではございません。
But of course, this does not mean that we are shutting down Final Fantasy 14 and ending the game.
They shut it down.
6.1 からはハイデリン、ゾディアーク編とは異なる新しい物語をスタートさせていくつもりです。
Beginning in patch 6.1, this will mark the beginning of an entirely new adventure separate from
the amount of people that are
Zodiac Heidelin saga.
So dumb.
そしてですね、
yeah.
同時にですね、
they're having, they're giving themselves five patches to set up an entire new arc.
And then I've also seen some people thinking that
Probably, yes.
right,
Shibuya is leaving the project at this point.
私はやめません。そのまま、もうなんかほぼライフワークなので、言われるまでは、ライフワークのように Final Fantasy 14続けていきますので、ぜひ、ね、まあ、もちろん楽しみに遊んでいただきたいんですけど、
Get your mind that's like Yoshi.
死ぬまで頑張ろうかなと思ってるので、
I mean, the man brought back the game from the ashes, so...
僕もよろしくお願いします。
It's like he's fucking newborn.
But I want to assure everyone that I'm not going anywhere. I'm not leaving the project.I look at Final Fantasy 14 as
Yoshi
my life
leave.
Work,
Yoshi
or at least until
me.
The president tells me to stop. But for me, yes, 6.0 will be ending the story, but from 6.1 on, we have an even greater story.
Oh my god,
and
dude, what the fuck are they going to bring to the
fucking game? I
feel
that I'm probably
going to
end up being with Final Fantasy 14 for my whole life.
はい、時々ね、そろそろやめんじゃないのみたいなの出るんですけど、やめるときはちゃんと言いますし、まあ、やめる気はないので大丈夫です。はい。
Every now and then I do hear a lot of rumors about people thinking that I might quit and leave the project. If I will leave the project, I will make sure I let you all know. But for now, I feel that this is my life work and I have no plans on leaving.
結構厳しいですね、皆さんね。死んでも続けろって書いてある。
People are telling me that I continue this even after I die. Necromancer? Necromancer?
Dude, it's
a DPS word.
I'm just failing DPS with a scythe.
自分は死んで
る。
ああ、なるほどね。はい、頑張っていきます。
I swear, Koji just gave it away.
Alright, I'll do my best.
I don't think it's gonna be Necromancer. Because it's a male DPS. And Necromancer is like a caster.
Use the
scythe! No.
Well,
they're gonna call it Necromancer and give him a scythe.
Again, please, do not worry.
Just make a Reaper, though.
Very hard on the 6.0 story, and we believe it's something very exciting. And
dude, it's not the same thing.
It's the same thing.
It's not, though.
A Reaper.
Yeah, a Reaper rips soul. It doesn't wake up fucking zombies.
You said it had to be zombies.
Okay, well,
yeah, you're right. To the moon! 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 To the
So, your journey up until now has taken you to another world, the first, where you became the Warrior of Darkness and averted the destruction of the star. And it was there that you learned of the final days, these calamitous events that gave birth to Zodiark and Hydaelyn.
Well, Zodiark, so say Hydaelyn, to a Ima Donatino Katokane. Sveteno Nazo, Tokia Kastame, Prayer no Mirasan, Hikarino Senshiwa, Tsuini, Waxe Hydaelyn, Hanarino
Senshi,
Kieto Mukaki, Katoni Arimas.
So, what is going on with Zodiark and what is going on with Hydaelyn? How does their story end? We'll learn all about that as well as. Depart from Hydaelyn and move to the moon.
多くのですね、人から受け取った思いを受け継いで、光の戦士はハイデリン・ゾディアーク編最後の謎に挑んでいきます。
People across Hydaelyn are putting all of their hopes and dreams into the Warrior of Light to save them from this, and so this will be a journey that will take the Warrior of Light there to find out what's going on and to save the planet.
テレポしたら、なんとたったの999
ビルで買いだ
っけ Someone's commenting that for the low low price of 999 gil, you can teleport to the moon?
ねえ、99万ギルとか取られるかもしれないね。
What? 90,000 gil to the moon.
でまあ、これまでね、ハイドリン・ゾディアーク編、
シ
ュクロビランズでもかなりの謎を解き明かしてきましたが、まだまだ多くの謎が残ってます。
So a lot of questions have been answered up until now in our expansions, but there's still a lot of questions that are left to be answered.
Curiouser, curiouser, burning question from in. What broke about the final days?
そもそも
what became of Hydaelyn and Zodiark? What would be the Guardians and Empire phase? What is seen as a fundamental thing? What is to be found on
the moon? What became of Hydaelyn and Zodiark, and what is happening with them now?
そしてガレマール帝国という、まあ、もともとね非常に強い軍事力でエオルゼアを支配していたガレマール帝国はどうなるのと。
And then of course you have the Garlean Empire, you know, once a very, very powerful force across the whole realm. What has happened to them? What is their fate?
そして活動し始めたゼノスとアシエン・ファダニエルの目的は何なのか。
And what are Zenos and the Ashians Fan Daniels, aim and what is their plot?
そしてですね、月行くのはいいけど、そもそも空気とかね。あるのみたいな。何あるの月って。
And so you know, all know we're going to the moon, but how are we going to get there? Is there any air on the moon to breathe? What is on the moon? What type of monster?
はい。まあこれらを、僕ら全力で皆さんにすべてきれいに、ストンと
解き明かされていくよう
全力でお届けしようと思います。
The dev team is currently working very hard on this story to make something very exciting and to give you all the information you need and answer all of those lingering questions.
まあもちろんね、その時光の戦士がどうなっていくのか、それから暁の決明のメンバーがどうなっていくのか、それからですね、託された古代人たちから託された思いというのはどうなるのか、それらはぜひ皆さんの目でお確かめください。
So all of these questions will be answered, not just the fate of the Warrior of the Light,the Warrior of Light, but also the fate of the Scions, and we'll find what is the dying wish of the Ancients. All this and more we'll find out in Endwalker's main scenario.
まあね、月行ったらね、エヴァンゲリオンとかね、埋まってるかもしれないね。
エヴァンゲリオン。エヴァンゲリオン。In the moon up there?
さあ、ではちょっと、
FFX はエヴァンゲリオン
から見ていきましょう。
Alright, so let's have a closer look at the characters that we saw in the trailer.
まずアルフィノ
ですね。今回、ジョブ
賢者にジョブチェンジしています。アルフィノが着ている衣装が、
ジョブ賢者
のジョブ専用装備のアルフィノバージョン。
Other class.
You think?
So first up, we have Alfino, our new resident sage.
Who's it gonna be?
That he's wearing in the trailer is the sage AF gear, but it's been designed especially for him.
まあ、転生組のアシエンファダニエルですが、グレーヘンに登場したアサヒというキャラクターの体を、利用する彼の目的がね、果たして何なのか。結構ね、彼ね、嫌われてるんですよね。
Lot of people love to hate this guy.
ただですね、大丈夫、ご安心ください。彼はラスボスではございません。
Do not worry, he is not the last boss. I mean,
まあラスボスじゃないんですけど、まあ彼にはね、さらに実はまだ大きな秘密があるんですが、そちらもかなり完全なスポイラーになるので
、
単純なお話ではないというのだけお伝えしています
。Really? No, I don't think it's.
And he's keeping a pretty big secret, a very complex secret.
It was in Stormblood.
If you say any more, it'll be too much spoilers, so we're going to stop right here.
はい、そしてトレーラーもう一人出てましたね。
Right, and last but not least, we have...
ゼノス、彼もまたですね、表舞台へと登場しそうですが、まあ、彼の望みはもうとにかく、友である皆さん、光の戦士と英雄と再戦したいというだけです。
And he's ready to take the stage once again. And he has a singular purpose. His one purpose in life is to battle with his...friend and enemy,
which I thought is interesting because I went through Stormblood. I'm like, man, this dude is depressed as fuck.
Yeah, yeah, もちろんね、皆さんが彼のことを友達だと思ってないというのは僕もよく知ってます。
I guess people didn't pick up that he was actually depressed the entire time. I guess that went past their heads when they did Stormblood.
But he most certainly feels that way about you. You are his friend.
まあどうやらね、彼もなんかまた若干コスチューム違う気もしますが、さてどうなっていくのか、
お楽しみに。 And it does look like he has a change of wardrobe as well, but to find out any more, we'll have to play Endwalk.
さあ、行月のフィナーレではですね、もっとたくさんのキャラクター登場してですね、ある意味ハイデリン・ゾディアク編、皆さんが10年以上にわたって、冒険してきた、一旦の総決算になる予定なので、どんなキャラクターが入り乱れてくるのか、ぜひご期待ください。
And you know, it has been 10 years since the beginning of this Highland and Zodiac saga, and you've met a lot of characters along the way, and we hope to bring back a lot of those characters for this story in 6.0.
まあ、ストーリーについてはね、すべての謎を解き明かしていくので、ちょっとこれ以上はネタバレが多すぎるので、ここまでにさせていただきますが、
So there are a lot more mysteries regarding the game's story, but it's so hard to talk about it further without revealing any spoilers. So.
まあ漆黒のヴィランズでもね、驚いたいただいたように、ファイナルファンタジー14開発チームがね、そんな単純な話で終わるかというのだけなんとなく思っておいてもらえれば、びっくりしてもらえる仕掛けたくさん用意していきたいと思います。
And you know, as was the case with Shadowbringers, this story is not going to be a simple one. It's going to be a very complex and intricate story that will sure to bring lots of surprises and excitement.
はい、では、続いて、
Shadowbringers left the bar really high though.
ゼロ、エンドウォーカーの全体像についてちょっとお伝えしていこう。
Oh no, after the last batch.
Okay, now that we've talked a little bit about the story, let's get into actually some of the content that will be making into the game.
I still haven't done last batch.
さあ、まず最初のセクションこちらです。
So we're gonna start
with...
Yeah, I
got bored and
stopped. Oh, change to the yours? Do you have changes?
Level cap が解放となります。
Expected.
Increasing the level.
But nice.
That armor though.
Which one?
The
Wayumi
Shop?
No,
all of them. No, all of them. No, all of them. No, all of them. No, all of them. No, all of them. No,
all of them. No, all of
them. No, all of them.
No, all of them.
No, all of them. No, all of them.
No, all of them.
No, all of
them. No, sorry, that's Dragoon. This is your last one, Dragoon.
ずいぶん頑張って続けてきたね。
No,
it's Dark Knight, Way Mage, Samurai, and then Black Mage.
Oh, okay. The way I saw it, it was like
今回も過去の拡張と同じ規模で、フィールドの追加を行っていきます。
So you cannot have, an expansion without
the Dark Knight one looks fucking amazing.
And we're planning to add new locales on the same scale as we have
the Samurai one may also be a Red Mage.
ではですね、
Dude, that's so colorful! Holy fuck, that's nice!
一部だけ、今日はちょっと一部になっちゃいますが、ご紹介していこうと思います。
So today we can't show much.But we do have a few screenshots and pieces of artwork to show.
It wouldn't be a first fan fest if they showed anything.
まずはですね、ショータウン。
So we're starting off with one of our smaller towns.
Smaller town.
No, no, no.
ご紹介したいと思います。
こちら。Smaller.
どこだこれ。
Wonder where this is.
Super.
こちらの名前は。
Dude, that's nice. That's a town.
町になります。
That's
name.
Dude.
Razatan.
もうちょっと近づいたね。
You're like the super merchant ones, so this makes sense.
Let's take a closer look.
Dude, that's so colorful. I like this.
This is a screenshot of maybe the entrance, the main entrance gate to the city.
ラザハンはプレイヤーの皆さんに
ラザハン。
14って拡張するとってこうダイタウンとショータウンっていうのがあって、漆黒のヴィランズだと、
it looks like,
まあユールモアに該当する場所だと思ってください。クリスタリウムじゃなくて。
So, with each expansion,
we usually
Middle Eastern or like
that's what I was gonna say.
America,
one smaller town and one larger town.
It's Middle Eastern, yeah.
Middle Eastern, yeah, yeah.
For 6.0, kind of on the same scale as Yulmore from 5.0.
じゃあ 6.0 でいうクリスタリウムに該当する大タウンはどこなんだよって聞かれるとそれはまだ内緒です。
As for whether the large town is going to be like, we really cannot talk about that yet.
No,
it's gonna be on the moon.
Let's go inside the town. Take a look.
Dude, I love this fineness. It's so fine colorful.
今までのファイナルファンタジー14のまた文化圏にないところへ、行っていただくことになるかな。
Right? Right?
A little bit different from anything that we've seen in Final
Fantasy. I like Stormblood, but like...
これどこなんだっていうとです
ね。Oh, look, brown, Eli. Look, favorite brown.
But it's got colors. Final
Fantasy 14のシナリオにこれまで、
Yeah, but Heron's Sword is colorful.
The giant crystal cliff thing in the background.
That crystal thing cliff is nice.
Well,
it's a cannon. It's
a lot of players that have been playing 14 for a long time will know, have heard the term
Thavnir,
the region of Thavnir, as it has appeared a lot since the early days of Final Fantasy 14.
We have Bismarck, we have the cooler Bismarck, and we have Space Bismarck.
Remember, the dancer, most of the original dancer outfits and fashion comes from the island of Thavnir.
そのサベネアと一つがまるっと新しい
そうです。そうです。そうです。そうです。そうです。そ
うです。そうです
。そうです
。そうです。そうです。そうです。そうです。そうです。
そうです
。そうです。そうです。そうです。
そうです。そうです。そうです。そうです。そうです。そう
です。そうです。そうです。そうです。そうです。そうです。そうです。そうです。そうです。そうです。そうです。そうです。そうです。そうです。そうです。そうです。そうです。そうです。そうです。そうです。そうです。そうです。そうです。そう
です。そうです。そうです。そうです。そうです。そうです。そうです。そうです。そうです。そうです。そうです。そうです。そうです
もう一個紹介していきましょうじゃあ。
Right, let's take a look at another location.
Dude, what the fuck is this?
なんだこれみたいな。
What?
This is probably the moon.
This is completely different.
No, this is the Garlean Empire.
This,
こちら。
On the map, they had like this red tower. See, I knew it.
Yeah.
I told you.
帝国の首都のはずである。
We're going to Arleman, another part on the fucking bingo.
This reminds me of Final Fantasy 15.
Fan Daniel's gonna put the capital of the Garlean Empire, moon antenna at Garlemald.
Although it looks a little like it's broken down a bit.
こちらもですね、ちょっと見てみましょう、スクリーンショットね。
Let's take a look at a screenshot.
いやなんだか。
It's all fucking
どんな国だったのかなと思いきや、ボロボロになってますね。
So we always thought of the Garlean Empire as
a
majestic place, but if you look at it here, it's pretty run down. I wonder what happened to it.
まあ一体ね、どういう経緯でこうなっているのか、それから光の戦士の皆さんはどういう経緯でここを訪れることになるのか、謎ね、いっぱいあります。
So how did this area turn this way, and why does the Warrior of Light have to go there, and what
will
he or she find
there? The beginning of the game.
まあ、ここでもね、非常に大きなドラマが光の戦士皆さんを待ち受けています。
行く時はですね、ぜひここ
に向かってい
ただきたいと思います。point
five. For your journey there.
We might see something about it in 5.5.
そしてですね、まあ、新しいフィールドがあると当然
新しい5.5 が出てきます。Well, you always get the, like,crazy
and of course,
shit
what would new areas be without
new
ones. Tribes to live in them?
Still, gosh. Heavensward 0.5.
Moon people.
Newest tribe revealed. One more in the thing, in
so,
the bingo.
So in 6.0, you will be meeting some new tribes.
We knew they were going to happen, but like, what are they going to be?
Moon aliens.
So this artwork, yeah, you can see right in the middle is the Namazu kind of there.
I don't see a dwarf.
Like he's the best, the leader. He's the hero.
Holy fire, you're just marching. What the fuck are you going to
It's going to be forgotten.
No, but the face are there changing.
So our new tribe that you will be meeting
the
are Matanga,
the Fates,
and it's the Arcasodra tribe.
They're not. Oh, the Souls. Yeah,
they are. They could have the
Souls in world.
Some people may recognize
elephant.
This.
Yeah,
they might
they're,
be the.
非常に敵対してくるあのモブハントのモンスターがいたりするんですけど、その中でも有効的なのが
アルカソドラ
で。先ほど紹介したサベネア島で出会いが待ってると思います。
So,
Matanga.
Especially
the
players.
See,
where have you seen this?
Encountered one of these.
That's what I was saying. Is it sound like just the word Matanga sounds
for
some reason like elephants to
what?
I hate
elephants. And then they said Azim Steps. So I'm like, oh, the woolly mammoth thingies, which are basically elephants.
I hate
this.
ゾウモチーフで。いろんなね、こうグラフィックス出てると思いますけど、いよいよ、
how, so the, まあ、その地域に足を踏み入れるのか。まあ、二人
騎士って言われてる。
we players may recognize some of the.
Wait, do we have this like? Do we have this beast tribe already in the game?
The,
no.
No.
That they've gone on in the past. We're finally going to that area, and seeing the inspiration.
You don't need the inspiration. Remove it.
Statue work.
まあ、獣人は他にもいるんですけど、もうちょっと、公開を待っていただきたいと思ってます。
I wonder how the female. I don't know.
We have many more.
The females are just
going to
look the same.
But
you think?
Probably. It's
a male.
They don't have different looking.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah.
You're
right.
Noticed this. None of them.
No, I didn't. I don't pay that much attention.
Going
to
what could be on the moon.
というわけでそのうちまたご紹介していこうと思います。
And that's enough.
There's no actual the fucking one on the moon. This one on the moon.
They showed
what
was that?
That
was four zones. Yeah. Was that three?
They showed two
threats to deal with.
No, they showed three.
They showed Davnir, Garlemald, whatever this thing is.
What's this?
And this is
what I'm talking about. Wait, this is from 10. Yeah, this is from 10.
Final Fantasy.
Now it says 10.
Fatah はちょっとわかる。
New Braimel then?
So if there are fans of Final Fantasy X out there, they might recognize
Anima from X.
This creature.
Yeah, Anima.
Anima という異形と出会うことになりそうです。
His name is Anima.
で、まあ今回ですね、あの Final Fantasy X の時にアニマを作画したあのスタッフは Final Fantasy XIV のアートスタッフでもあるんですよ。
You know what that means?
14用に
改めてアニマ
を、No, please no.
14用にですね、まあいろいろ理由があるんで。
So Davnir, they showed Razathan, which is just
the original.
They showed
the
city with the giant crystal behind. They showed the city that was like a giant tree, like a giant tree.
The name for the giant crystal area? Because it's like, it's like, yeah, okay. So we saw it. Building a name.
No, but Thavanir.
Challenging new dungeons. They're not going to be challenging.
Thavanir one
was. Is that that's Garlemald on the right?
Yeah, the one on the right is Garlemald. The other one is the other city.
But this is like underground Garlemald where the moon antenna.
I'm pretty sure they showed four. Oh, what the fuck is that boss?
This is mostly art today, I guess.
Would you guys say this is a new dungeon showcase?
Yeah, okay. That's
what, that's literally what this is. Yeah. We're getting close to the end of the world. This was a Thavnir dungeon, because that's an Indian deity type thing.
It's not Shiva.
Ruins and large
no, it's not Shiva.
No, Shiva
has multiple arms.
It looks a little bit like Thavnir, but I mean, it's tricky, isn't it? Because don't they have like multiple...
Oh, you know, this one reminds me of the Eerie, it's one of the dungeons in Heaven's War.
Looks, very biological. The Nidhogg Slayer one?
Yes. What's that on the middle?
We have this as well.
Okay, this is Garland, clearly.
Yes, but like this, because it's like the moon antenna corrupted Garlemald.
Yeah.
Activate the cannon in Daphne
to assist the moon. Clearly.
Good to see they're pulling from 15 in here.
And so, with... As usually is the case with our dungeons that we add, you'll be visiting most of them during the main scenario. But this time we have a wide variety of dungeons, some that are very high fantasy, some that have maybe ancient ruins, as well as some that have a very
okay, but how easy are they going to be?
変化に富んだダンジョンをいろいろ現在ね、ものすごい勢いで制作中なので、
is that fun? I don't care if there is.
We're currently
like,
in the process of
creating the newest one is fucking easy, but I really enjoy it.
それではさらにバトルコンテンツちょっと続けていこうと思うんですが、まあ皆さんが
just visuals. The visuals are really nice.
大きな要素の一つ
か。Visuals only carry dungeon so much.
Hey, now we're going to talk about another one of our battle contents we have planned.
希望のそのエデンというシリーズが、パッチ5で
無事に完結して
、我々開発チーム新しい高難易度レイドの8人レイドの開発に取り組んでます。
And so, with the story of Eden finally concluded, we've been hard at work
preparing
a new Eden
person. I didn't think the end of Eden was as hype as the other ends.
No.
Agreed.
I didn't like the end of Eden.
It's too early to give details, but we have some art to show you.
The ending was great.
No, yeah, it was.
We're fighting an ant. Whose mask is that? Is that...
I don't know. I can't help you there.
Is that Mahavir? I don't remember!
Nah, it's gonna be the little kid.
Yeah, this mark, we've seen it somewhere before.
The UQ? Laha...
Yes! Laha Brea.
It's Laha Brea.
Laha has got the...
Laha
has got the... He's got the fangs in his red mask and it looks like a butterfly.
Pandemonium.
Pandemonium.
Oh, no. Can't tell you the title. The title will be
Pandemonium. No, it's gonna involve the Emperor.
このレイドはですね、どんな場所で、行われるのかというのはちょっと
知
っ
ており
ますかなり特殊かなと思ってます。
Basically the name of the raid.
We cannot talk about
where
this
raid
is going to be very very unique. Final Fantasy IV.
まあ今回ね、6.0 でハイデリン、ゾディアーク編というのをきれいに一旦完結させますので、まあ
それも含めて、ゲイブ・ウェスウィン・サーバッジ・ポーク。
まあ残された謎にまた、挑んでいくという形で、完全
I don't know what you're talking about, mate. It is already
savage. お届けしていこうと思います。
In conjunction with that story that we're completing
the
Highland of Zodiac chat Saga,
we plan to have a lot of shit going on, like
completely
actually.
Original Final Fantasy XIV story of Pandemonium.
はい。もちろん、高難レイドはね、高難易度だけではなく、アライアンスレイドも、新しいシリーズをお届けしていこうと思います。
New Alliance Raid.
It's not going to only, we're not only going to be releasing
my favorite one still probably Heaven's War or
someone.
The Void Arc series is by far the coolest and the most fun. I think the Nier ones are mechanically the most interesting.
The Nier ones I hate.
Really?
What's wrong with
the Nier ones?
The story makes absolutely no fucking sense.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know what the problem with that is? That fucking Yoko Taro said that it was canon. Or something like that.
In the background, we're also working on
But for fucking Yoko Taro, everything is canon. Yeah, yeah.
We still need one more near one, though, don't we?
Yes,
5.5. It's probably his fear, man. It's probably his fear, man. It's probably his fear, man. But Eorzea にある古くからある大きな謎を扱っていくので、まあ、14との中の、サーガ完結、1個目のサーガ、ね、完結に向けてかなり濃い話になっていくので、これもぜひ楽しみにしてください。
So we plan to release more info on this new Alliance raid at our digital fan festival. But we'd like to tell you that it is a completely original Final Fantasy XIV original Alliance raid. It's not a crossover. And it will be centering on a piece of Eorzean lore that has remained steeped in mystery for a long time.
Which one is it?
Yeah, there's still a lot of questions that haven't been answered.
It's going to be Mercidia.
What's that?
The Hildebrand?
Where
Hildebrand?
Where the cat people are from and the dragons.
Alright, let's continue on.
If they say it like that, that's the only like, ancient
BB.
What else could it be?
So we're also working on new PvP content. That is more small scale than what we currently have.
2v2.
But Feast,
That feels more casual, more immersive.
Because the one that always comes up is the Earthquake for 3 for the Alligans. The Flood, which was the 6th one.
7th
was Bahamut.
Apparently the first one involved a good kingdom of Bahamut.
Something that makes magic easier than before. And casual, yet immersive.
Okay, so it could be Mercidia or it could be Charlemagne.
And we're also working on a new type of
We already found the Charlemagne home city in Stormblood.
That doesn't focus solely on gear. Of course, there'll be gear, but we want to have a new category of reward as well. To, again, open this up to
PvP
a lot rewards.
Of new players.
We did find the city of Charlemagne city in
Stormblood. In addition to battle content, we also have a lot of other content as well.
Are you saying Eureka?
Yeah. The entire place was a city.
No, that was part of
Charlemagne.
So we
are planning to add a lot of new quests.
It was an Isle of Valor.
これまではタンク、ヒーラー、近接DPS、遠隔DPS という4つのロールに分けてロールクエストを展開してました。So up until now, there were originally four categories
that we split these role quests into: tank, healer, melee DPS, and range DPS.
さすがにちょっとざっくりしすぎてたなという反省からですね、タンク、ヒーラー、近接物理DPS、遠隔物理DPS、魔法DPSというふうにロールを1個追加してクエストをご用意しようと思ってます。
We're going to now be expanding that from 4 different types to 5 different types, making it tank, healer, melee physical DPS, ranged physical DPS, and
should
have
been
looked at
in the first place.
まあその分ね、体験にちゃんとフォーカスしやすくなるので、クオリティ高いものをお届けしていこうと思ってます。
And this will allow us to focus more directly on each type of role and make a deeper story.
もちろんあのギャザラクラフターの皆さんに向けたこれですね。For the role quest? Yes, the healer one? Yeah, okay. The healer one was the best.
And then there's also plenty of role quests that are planned for crafting gathers as well, such as those offered in 5.0's The Crystalline Mean.
The melee DPS and the tank one or whatever.
I want to tell you more about it, but because we haven't talked about the large town yet, I can't say anything.
Was the healer one with the dwarf?
Yes.
The
monk one.
Of course, there won't be just role quests
That's
for crafters,
cool monk
but also we've developed plenty of new craftable gear as well.
それから続いてフェイスシステムにも、アップデートがあります。
All right, next is an update to our trust system.
今月のフィナーレに向けてフェイスの NPC が追加となります。
We will be adding a special certain one, someone to join you as a companion.
まあきっとね楽しみにしてる人いると思うんだよな。
A lot of you have been waiting for this guy.
I'm itself.
Oh, sweet.
この方
I knew that was gonna happen. I expected that.
Wait, did you have Steam yet?
No.
I've never used Trust, so I don't know.
近接 DPS として参加するので、暁の決命、近接 DPS 足りない問題というのもこれで解決するかなと思います。
So, Estinian will be joining the Trust System as, of course, a Dragoon. And then being a melee DPS character, this will...Hopefully, help alleviate that glaring lack of melee DPS characters in the Scions.
まあ彼がねどういった経緯で暁まあ彼ね結構一人で動くの好きですから暁と行動を共にするようになるかというのは近日リリースされるパッチ 5.5 とそれからあのそのあたりからのねメインストーリーの流れをぜひ注目していてください。
But again, why would a lone wolf like Estinian?Join this group of the Scions. You have to wait and find out, but information is coming if you play in
5.5.
No, he won't betray us. He won't betray us.
Final Fantasy series の竜騎士って結構裏切るからね。
Dragons in Final Fantasy usually betray.
Wait, really?
まあ一回やってるから多分大丈夫だと思うんですよね。
He's betrayed once. He won't do it again.
フェイスというシステムの活用は、まあ、これに、まあ、キャラクターの追加にとどまらず一応今実は計画していることはあるんですけどまだ今ちょっと計画中なので今日具体的にお知らせするのが難しいです。
And of course, we have further plans for the trust system, not only just adding new characters, but also making adjustments to that system as well. But we cannot talk about them yet today because it's still a little bit too early.
はい。キャラを追加するだけじゃなくて、フェイスを利用してこんなことさらにできるよみたいなところっていうのは今後の PLL とかでも進捗があり次第お伝えさせていただこうと思ってます。
Again, not just adding new characters, but also adding new types of activities and types of duties for your companions to take part in. Again, we won't talk anymore today about it, but we have exciting information coming up in future producer letter lines.
はい、そしてですね、続いてこちらゴールドソーサーにも新たなコンテンツの追加を予定しています。
Give me my gambling.
Right, we're also planning an update to the gold saucer with new content.
特にですね、規模としてはドマ式麻雀というものにまあ並ぶぐらいちょっと大きなものを今計画しております。
So good, so good.
The plan is to add something almost as big as the recent edition of Mahjong.
みんなどういうものが欲しいんだろうな。
What does everybody want?
ブリッツボール。
やっぱりこう。
Oh no.
ブリッツボール。
ブリッツボール。
ブリ
ッツボール。
You can bet on games.
ブリッツボール。ブリッツボール。
Did they say ブリッツボール? Fall Guys.
No, they're reading the comments.
They're reading the comments again.
なんか。
Fucking Fall Guys.
今回のレイドで落ちたりしてるもんね。あとスノーボードね。
スノーボーディングもね。スノーボーディング。スノーボーディング。
スノーボーディング。スノーボーディング。
ただ相撲って言ってる人いるんで、ね、さっきからね。
スノーボーディング。スノーボ
ーディング。はい。ちょっとこれまだ詳細が言えないので、ただかなり大きな、しかもプレイヤーの皆さんのキャラクターを使って楽しんでいける、まあしかも誰でも楽しんでいけるような新しい、まあしかもね、マルチプレイできるような。コンテンツを今計画します。これも、もうちょっとしたら多分お伝えできると思うので、お伝えしていこうかなと思ってます。
We plan on it being, again, like we said, plan on being very big, something for all players, multiplay. But again, we can't talk much about it now, as we're not, haven't enough to tell you. But we do have details coming in the future, so please look forward to it.
マージャンをね丸ごと入れてしまうようなクレイジーな
コンテンツ
ですから、
ま
あ何が来るのかいろいろ予想をしていただければと思います。
I mean the team is crazy enough to put the full game of Mahjong into 14, so we know.
リエスのハドレマヤン。
続いては新コンテンツになります。
Alright, the next we're going to introduce a new piece of content.
New content.
New content.
Farming.
さて何や。
Wait, we have farming already.
あります。
Kinda.
You can, from the artwork, you can see that it looks pretty fun and relaxing.
It's gonna be fucking
farming.
Harvest Moon Boy.
タイトルをですね。
Island Sanctuary.
Is this if this is their answer to having our own houses, I'm totally okay with that.
Final Fantasy IV.
What do you mean our own house? Like our own instance?
So one of the complaints, right, is people can't have their own house. If they do this and get their own,
we're currently working on this content where Final Fantasy XIV players' adventures can enjoy a bit of slow living.
ギャザラークラフターをプレイしていなくても楽しむことができます。
And again, this is not just something that is limited to crafters and gatherers. Anyone can play this.
まあもちろんね、やってる人にも特典はあるんですけど、みんなプレイできる。
Of course, crafters and gatherers will be able to do different types of things here, but of course, this is something for everyone.
まあ例えばですけど、動物の飼育をしたり。
For example, you might be raising animals.
まあ、島を開拓してね、そこで取れた特産物で貿易をしていったり。
And maybe cultivating the land of this uninhabited deserted island, and then taking the fruits of your labor and selling them.
ミニオンを放し飼いにしたりと、そういった要素満載でスローライフをね、楽しむためのコンテンツになっております。
Maybe throwing your minions out there on the range and letting them roam.
Do it, please.
Sounds pretty fun.
で、まあ、結構あってですね。これ開発チーム、これね、日本人限定のネタで申し訳ないんですけど、我々開発最初のコードネーム、ダッシュ島って言ってました。
Ah, so the dev team has been calling this island the Dash Island from a Japanese TV show.
いや、本当にズバリそういう、まあ、楽しみ方できるといいよね、みたいな。
It's kind of like that, where you take a deserted island and you, you know, make it into something that's your own.
Oh, that's nice.
こちらですね、パッチ 6.x シリーズ全体を通じてアップデートし、開拓を進めていくみたいな、構想で今、開発を進めてますので、ほのぼのと Final Fantasy 14を楽しんでいる皆さん、ぜひね、期待いただければと思います。
So, players will be able to enjoy the activities in the sanctuary over the entirety of the 6.x series as we updated. And so, I hope you're looking forward to it and the slow life that it brings.
そして皆さん現在進行形でですね、パッチ 5.4 で、非常にね、とある地域の復興に努力を捧げてきてくださいました。
Next up is something that I believe you guys are all currently working on.
Yeah,
give me the house. When? Tell me when I have to log in.
大変強く尽力してくださいました。
I still don't like
it. Crafters all over the world have poured their heart.Into the rebuilding of the firmament and the scars of
inspiration. Restoration.
No, the actual city, like, opening.
の気持ちとしてですね、冒険者に居住区を開放したいとおっしゃっております。
And inspired by that work, there is the city is wants to present a new housing area to those that have worked hard to rebuild the firmament.
これまで 4.0 の時かな。ハウジングエリア追加した時と同じで 6.0 がスタートしたタイミングで、冒険者居住区のエリア開放はします。
So, just like it, we have since 4.0, at the release of 6.0, we will be opening the area for players to go in and look at.
ただし、やることすごいたくさんあるので、まあ、この土地にしようかなっていう見学をしてもらって、パッチ 6.1 のタイミングで購入できるようにというふうにしていきますので、ぜひですね、6-0相手ちょっとゲームプレイ落ち着いたらどうしようかなみたいなのを話し合ってもらえればと思います。
So at the launch of 6.0, players can go to the residential area and look around and see what you know might be a good place to
see which place you want to come.
But the actual purchase of that won't be available till 6.1 because again, there's a lot of stuff to do.
Oh, 6.1.
Before.
So
this is how they've always done it.
Okay.
Because like, you don't want people like rushing to have launch to like do shit.
Right.
で用意させていただきますし、もちろんアパートメントもございます。
And currently the plan is to have the exact same number of wards as all of the other housing residential districts in Eorzea, as well as having apartments as well.
で、まあ、もちろんね、全体的にその継続してね、土地不足であるというお声たくさん頂戴しているので、そちらの努力も合わせて続けていこうと思います。
And because we understand this is very important for players and a lot of feedback has been given about this, we are continuing our efforts to make sure that there will be enough plots available.
There's not.
Definitely not.
今回ね、皆さんが復興していただ
い
た
のは、商店街なので、まあ、全く
それと同じ
ぐらいに行く
かって言われると、さあ、まあどうなりますかっていう感じではあります
けど、
まあ大体イメージは掴んでもらえるんじゃないかなと思います。
and whether or not it will be exactly like the firmament that
you're building like in the gacha games, where you have your, like, your own like area where you have where you can put your chill, I guess.
Will look like.
Hi.
And people can
if we could put housing items on the island, oh my god, housing market would explode.
It can't
happen because they would have to be saving the data on there.
Yeah,
how are they going to do this then?
Alright, so I think we've the whole covered all the types of new content that we can talk
they already have an
today,
issue with like not being able to have so much housing
in,
stuff.
Future shows.
ちょっと大事なですね、この 6.0 からバトルシステムのメンテナンス、大きくちょっとね、2項目あるので、お伝えしていきたいと思います。
But now we want to talk a little bit about two important updates and adjustments that we'll be making to the battle system.
当然、これまでの拡張パッケージ同様、バトルシステムの細かい調整とか、
ジョブアクションの
調整とか、新しいジョブアクションの実装というのは、普通にあります。
I hope they make it interesting.
So,as with previous expansions,
probably all the healers are going to get like big adjustments
when it comes to the battle system,
as well as job actions and the addition of new actions.
で、それ以外に重要なお知らせが2つあるので、その2つをお伝えさせていただきます。
And so today, the two announcements that I want to make are completely different from that.
まず1つ目。
Oh, number squish.
バトル計算式で使ってる数字のデノミネーションというのを行わせていただきます。
So the first big announcement today is that we will be performing a downscaling of the values, the numbers that we use in the calculations.
What does it mean?
これはですね、以前のライブストリームでもちょっとお伝えさせていただいてたんですが、まあこのタイミングでやること
を承知ください。It gets to a point where you can't, you know, read the lines.
So we have discussed this. I have discussed this in
previous
producer letters. And today I want to get into a little bit more detail
じゃあまあどういうものなのか、なんでそれをやるのかというのをちょっとご説明させていただきます。
So we want to tell you a little bit about what this entails, and what it means for you.
まあ新生オルゼアのリリース以降、レベルキャップ解放していくたびに各ジョブのね、
I think 100 is nice. ガンガンこう上がってきますね。Maybe 1000 is too much.
So since the release of A Realm Reborn, every increase to a job level cap sees an increase to the base job damage.
まあ大きなダメージが出せるっていうのはまあ気持ちいいな、確かに気持ちいい。爽快感はあるんですけど、パッと見るともう数字が大きくて分かりにくいっていうのと。扱う数字が僕ら大きくなるとすごい様々な問題っていうのが生まれてきてます。
So, and I understand, that it feels great to, you know, dish out a lot of damage to enemies, but after a certain point, it becomes very difficult, to easily discern the numbers on the screen, as well as,
you know,
as the numbers get bigger,
fucking
AC team
game.
increase on the
back. That's not gonna happen, but like it'd be cool.
まずこのデノミネーションさせていただく理由の一つ目なんですけど、まあ、バトル計算式は今回変わらないです。あの、メンテナンス、調整はあるかもしれないですけど、基本変わらないです。これは、あの、覚えておいてください。
If the number gets too big,
it takes longer, I guess?
No, well, a little bit. It's not that so much as, imagine, like,
we're not changing the formulas, we're changing the numbers that go into the
formulas. You have a box for, like, how much damage you can do, right? And the computer says, okay, you can put any number you want from, like, 1 to 2 million in here. If you put 2 million 1 in that box, suddenly...
数字が一周しちゃうみたいな現象っていうのが起こります、これ。
So this is a, a programming issue, but what happens a lot of times is when numbers get too big, it can cause overflow and revert things, back to different numbers, and that can cause a lot of bugs.
で、これなんとか、実は今まで出てきたバグでも、何件かこれにもう該当するものが出てるんですけど、なんとか 5.x 期間中は無理やり。やってきました。
A stream stop.
And we've had these problems in the past in the 510X series, and we've been able to patch them
in the second
emergency patches, but it's been just barely.
でまあこれ以上数字大きくなると、やっぱパケットのサイズ、皆さんとの通信のやり取りするパケットのサイズを増やしたりとか、そうなるとバグとか遅延っていうのが生まれちゃうので、数字を小さくさせてほしいっていうのがまず理由の一つ目になります。
But again, if data packets continue to increase in size because of these large numbers, it can stress communication loads to the server, and that will end up creating bugs and delays in the game, ruining the experience.
そしてですね、ヘイト計算式というのがもう限界に来ていてですね、扱う数字が大きすぎて、今タンクのヘイトって内部的にはもうキャップにずっと張り付いている状態を無理やりこう 位置下げたり上げたりっていうのをやってたりするので、もうこれ一周すると数字ゼロになっちゃったりするので、今ちょっと強引な対応している状態で動いてるんですけど、これらも整理させていただきたいと思ってます。
Well, because Enmity is an objective key practice, right? So they're already, what they're likely already doing is whatever damage you do is calculated and then divided by like 100 or something, and then goes into a pool for what the Enmity is. So because you have, you know, an entire party of people hitting something, it's that same overflow error. It's just they're trying to keep track of the Enmity. Yeah, like he's saying, it's like you're going to get to the max, and then suddenly, if they didn't do anything, what would happen is mid-fight, the tank would cap the enmity value, and then loop back to zero, so they would go to the bottom of the enmity list.
So large that it takes up a lot of space on the screen, as well as it's starting to affect the graphics rendering.
Yes, yes. If that's why they have to do this. If they don't do this, and they just let us keep getting higher and higher levels and more damage, you would get to a point where the tank enmity would loop back to zero. If it even does that, that would be the nicest thing that happens. On the worst end, it would just like straight up crash the game or something.
Ooh, I like numbers.
So, to prove our point, I'm going to show you the amount of HP that a certain boss coming in 5.5 has.
40.
Oh!
He won't probably kill that in 2 minutes.
Yeah, it sounds humongous, but like...
440 million.
この4億4千万をみんなで削り切る光の戦士たちもまあ大概
なんですけど、
I'm sure that
the
Warriors of Light will be able to
get this much HP down. I mean, it can be like the last boss of the 24 man.
わかったわかった。まあでまとめて、で何となのっていうのをちょっとじゃあ。
Extreme
So, trial. Let's talk a little bit about then we know the problems now. What are we actually going to do to
You think?
Them?
Is that an extreme trial?
レベル51からレベル80までの数値の差っていうのが小さくなります。
So
the first thing we're planning on doing is
truncating
the character growth from levels 50 to 80.
例えばですけど、レベルが一つ上がると適当な数字で言いますよ。5% これまで上昇してた。で、その 5% の積み重ねでどんどんプレイヤー数字でかくなってるんですけど、
I'm too dumb for a number.
まあそれをレベル51から80までの間をちょっと圧縮させていただいて、
yeah.
まあ極端な話を言うと 1% ずつしか強くなりませんみたいな形の調整をさせていただきます。
Okay, for example, again, the numbers that I'm going to be giving here are not the exact numbers, but this is just for an example. For example, you have the amount of progress that you make, the amount of that your attributes will go up after gaining one level. Let's say that it will be plus 5%. For levels 50 to 80, taking that from 5% up after each level to, say, 1% up after each level.
まあ、特にヒットポイントとか火力の上昇の差っていうのがこれまでに比べて当然少なくやっぱり感じられてしまうかなと。
And so this will again look like it's affecting player HP as well as the amount of damage that a player deals.
まあなのでちょっとアクション一撃のダメージっていうのがこれまでに比べるとやっぱり数字がちょっと小さくなることになります。
And so what this will appear to look like is that when you deal damage, it will look like your damage has gone down.
でその一方でなんですけど、レベル81から今回ね、6.0 でレベル90までキャップが上がるので、レベル81から90までっていうのはこれまでの同じ体感の成長度合いじゃないとつまんなくなっちゃうので、
で女子ピースモール皆さんは
ここの割合。
Final Fantasy actually like tests their things.
今までと同じ感覚になるようにするので
WoW has the closed beta people can participate in.
Yeah, and they told them about all these issues that they didn't fucking fix for months. So like, the fucking the beta for WoW is complete bullshit.
There's a glorified PR stone.
Yeah, that's exactly what it is. It's also dumb because you end up in situations where like people know the entirety of the fight before it even comes out. So like it launches, you know, and like you should know exactly how this raid works because everyone's already seen the raid for months now.
That could also be problematic. And
what the fight is that?
So what we want to do is we want to keep maintain that sense of progression between the levels 81 to 90. So while we would be truncating that progress from levels 50 to 80 and compressing that down from level 81 to 90, we will leave it in a position where it will feel the same as
so
it does
still feel
for
like
every
you're gaining
for those final 10 levels, those new 10 levels.
Yeah.
That's what I was about to ask for that. If they were gonna make it easier to learn that.
So the 経験値も全体的にギュッて圧縮します。
Experience point values are also becoming very too large, and so we'll be lowering them as well. And at the same time, we'll be reducing the amount of EXP needed to level up.
なので次のレベルまでに必要な経験値もギュッて減りますけど、敵からもらえる経験値も減るんで、相対的に感覚は変わらないです。
So again, relatively, it'll be the same. It'll be however, you'll be getting less experience for defeating an enemy, but it will take less experience to level up.
まあもちろんね、拡張新しく出てキャップ上がるんで、その分のなんだろう、レベルアップしやすさみたいなのまた調整していきますけど。
And again, we do, as we are releasing this new expansion, we are, you know, going to make it easier to level up, so that is going to remain.
で、まあ当然プレイヤーサイドの攻撃力、なんだダメージとかね、ヒットポイント下がるんだから、モンスターのヒットポイントやダメージっていうのも当然それに応じて小さくなります。
And again, this is not only for the players. Because player HP and attack numbers will be going down, we'll be doing the same thing for monsters as well, and so relatively everything will remain the same.
で、まあ結局どうなるかっていうと、まあプレイヤーが弱くなるわけではないですよ。扱う数字は小さくなりますけど、体感の感覚、やり取りしているものに関しては変わりませんと。
So what we want everyone to remember is that this is the character not getting weaker. The numbers are going down, but relatively everything is staying the same.
The smaller the numbers with me means we're getting weaker.
制限解除という遊びがございまして、レベル例えば80の状態で、過去のコンテンツへ、強いまま行くみたいなやつに関しては今よりもクリアが難しくなってしまうと思います。
There is one thing, however, that will be slightly affected by this change, and that is playing as undersized parties. For example, as level 80, going back and playing some of the old content as an undersized party.
Oh no!
This may
be that's what I thought.
ここはあのなんとかそのね遊びとしてその
そう、you guys wanna farm dogs?
なんとかしたいとは思ってるんですけど、今のところこうこれでなんとかなるだろうみたいなのがちょっとまだ見つかってないので、
because of the 51 to 80 stat squish per level is what's causing it. Only that part specifically.
部分に関してはちょっと今のところあのプレイヤーがねどうしても弱くなってしまう部分かなと思います。だから普通に制限解除とか関係なく遊んでる分に関しては数字のやり取りが小さくなるだけで別にプレイヤーが弱くなるわけではありませんよっていうのを、ご理解いただければと思います。
Regarding these undersized parties, we understand this is a large portion of what a lot of players enjoy doing, and so we understand that this is still something that we need to address. As to how we're going to address this, we're still in the process of finding that, so that's something for
the future. I mean, I'm thinking about it, I guess.
Otherwise, we want to, again, reiterate the fact that while the numbers here are going down, the player is not getting weaker. It's all relative.
This would only really affect...
So...で大体まずこのデノミネーションのところは大丈夫かな。
Yeah.
So you guys want to farm dogs?
The thing is, yeah.
大体今のレベル80ですね。僕のクロマ。
Heaven's Word and earlier will still be just as easy because we're so much higher. But that Stormblood stuff because of the squish, the 70 from 80 being squished.
So to give you an example.Currently, my
it's not that it would
player,
get harder, it's just that it would feel
80,
harder than
it
should
530.
Be.
If I use Fire 4 with no
You'd
crit
doing
and no direct hit, I deal
normal.
About 50,000 points of damage.
ぐらいかな
We expect this to go down to about 10,000.
で、まあ、そこからレベルが上がっていくと、oh. またあのいつもの拡張の、あのレベル1個ずつ上がっていった強くなった感覚っていうのは、やるので、まあ、大体5分の1ぐらいだと思ってもらえればと思います。
Of course, this will go up as the level goes up, but think of it as about reduced about 80% down to about a fifth.
で、これはあのやっぱり長期運営をやっていく上では、ちょっとどうしても避けられないポイントなので、
If it was me, I would have made it like a reduction of
100. 続けていきます。だから今回やったとしてもまた10年ぐらい経つともう一回デノミネーションさせてくださいってタイミングが来てしまうと思います。
The lower levels are going to be doing like one damage, like exaggerating.
They're going to be doing
one damage.
Which means
what you have to do is you have to adjust, yes, because you can't be doing, you can't take 5 and divide it by 100. What you do is you change the HP values
for many, many, many years in the future. And to ensure that we can do that, this is one of the
things that we need to do. Does less than 100
possibly
damage.
Another 10 years down the road, we might have to do this again.
You would
but
have to
again,
adjust the
this
enemies
is basically,
they hit.
We want, we're doing this to show to you that we're
health,
committed to having the
yeah, so basically
they have
to adjust like every
14,
fucking enemy in the game.
Keep going for many, many, many years.
Well, the lower.
Thank God,
right,
no more belt.
One more,
dude.
Q14 からですね、申請したとき、表示がなくなりつつも生き残ってきたこの装備なんですが、
Many of you remember back from 1.0, we had this item. It was there, and even though it was removed graphically, it remained.
ついにですね。
I would have liked for them to make it like.
But the time for belts.
Show visually. Itself removing, but this point.
You're saying that they had it show visually before, I assume in like 1.0 or
something.
Oh. They took away the visual, but it was still there.
Yeah.
で、あまりチェストワークはでも他と一緒だし、あのアライアンスレイドではもう邪魔だからドロップしないようにしてくれとか言われたんですよね。もうじゃあ今回消そうということになりました。
So again, as you know, belts have no bearing on players' outward appearances. Their stat values
How are we gonna hold our pants now?
Is pretty negligible. And they're not, and because of that, they're not a very popular piece of equipment. Yet, they take up the same amount of space in our armory chest as other equipment. And we've even had lots of fans ask us to just stop dropping them in alliance raids because we don't need them.
リングはっていう声もね結構今コメント多いんですけど指輪は
But rings are visual. We
have.
指輪もすごい検討したんですけどやっぱり左右別々のグラフィックスの指輪をつけるっていうことでおしゃれに使ってる人っていうのもいるので今回はやりませんでした。
And regarding rings, while we did consider this, we also understand that a lot of players becauseYou can put them on both hands, and you can actually graphically see them on your players on both hands. We decided that we're going to not do that this time.
I don't know.
で、結局どうなるかっていう説明をしていきます。
So, we need to explain what's going to happen with this removal of belts.
まず 6.0 以降、帯防具は装備不可になります。
Do they turn into money? What are they doing?
So, at the beginning, at the launch of 6.0, belts will no longer be equipable.
そして装備中のまま 6.0 を迎えた場合には自動的に外れて遺失物管理人という NPC が預かることになります。
So what happens to any belts that are equipped at the time of that switch over to 6.0? These will automatically be unequipped and moved to a calamity salvager.
リテーナーが装備したままとかいうのも全て遺失物管理人に我々移させていただきますので何かこう無理に急いで準備しなきゃいけないということはないようにさせていただきます。
This includes retainers as well. So, there is no need to rush and unequip any belts before that transition to 6.0. Everything will be moved to the Calamity Salvager automatically.
マテリアを、ね、外しておきたいという方は外しておいていただきたいです。
However, materia, if you want to remove materia from it, you should do that before 6.0.
で、各コンテンツから、それからあと交換とかからですね、帯防具一切排出停止となります。
Also, belts will no longer drop from any duties, and they'll be removed from elegant tonestone exchanges.
じゃあ分かったよと。腰防具なくなるのはもう分かったよと。じゃあその腰防具の35枠。どうすんだよと。
Okay, so now that we know that the belts are being eliminated, what happens to those 35 slots?
There we go.
Oh.
15枠を渋谷。
Oh my god.
そしてもう15枠をリングの方に回して、それぞれを50枠ずつに拡張します。
The plan is currently to take 15 of those 35 empty slots and allocate them to main arms, main weapons. Another 15 will be allocated to rings.
I understand the rings. Because we have two rings.
おい、残ってんじゃねえかよっていうところ
は、すいません。これ
からもなんとか枠を拡張していく。あの努力のためにもですね、5枠ちょっと1回リザーブとして僕らに預けてください。
And so there's a lot of people saying, well, wait a minute, 15 plus 15, that's 30. What about the other 5 slots? What's going to happen to those? We're going to take those and we're going to save them for a rainy day in case something happens. So we're going to keep those on reserve for now.
すいません、よろしくお願いします。
Sorry, but thank you.
はい。まあ、近づいてきたらね、また詳しくトピックスでお知らせしていこうと思いますので、ぜひチェックしておくようにしてください。
We will have a more detailed explanation of the removal of belts in an upcoming topics.
ではですね、そろそろ、今日お伝えできる情報っていうのも、少なくなってきたんですが、ここで、まあ、長期的に作ってきた新しいシステムを最後に、お伝えして終わっていこうかなと思ってます。
Right, so we're ending, we're nearing the end, of our announcement showcase, but we have one more system-related thing that we'd like to talk about that we've been working on for a long time.
こちら、データセンタートラベルという仕組みを、現在開発中でございます。
This huge
development of a new system called the data
center travel. Should have been the game a long time.
これはですね、今、
Jenny, stop worrying about the past. This is now.
まあ、ワールドを超えて、別のワールドへ遊びに行くワールド間テレポっていう仕組みがありますが。
So all of you know about the current system that we have that allows players to move around between worlds called the world travel system.
それをですね、まあ、ちょっと全くそれと同じ機能というのはちょっとサーバーの作り的に不可能なので、一旦ログアウトは必要なんですけど、キャラクター選択画面から他のデータセンターへ遊びに行くっていう新しい仕組みを今回、開発中です。
We'll have to make alt on different data centers.
So while this won't work the exactly the same way as the world visit system, we hoped that it can be similar. Although, it will require, again,changing the system outside of the game and then logging back in.
その代わり、他のデータセンターへ
遊びに行った場合に、like the login screen.
フリーカンパニーとか、リンクシェルのチャットができ
ない。ちょっと、
ワールドカンセルフォーよりは制限が強いんですけど、友達に会いに行ってパーティーを組んでコンテンツへ行くみたいなことっていうのはできるので、また改めて詳細にできることできないことっていうのの一覧がまとまったら皆さんにお伝えしていこうと思います。何はともあれデータセンターを超えて友達のところへ遊びに行けるシステムだと思ってください。
And so, there will be a lot of restrictions with this, possibly even more than there are currently with, the world visit system. However, this will allow players to...
No, that's
stupid. That's stupid. The entire point of doing it.
And party
it would
up
most
with
likely
friends,
be something like
have a lot of fun.
Not like having some kind of restriction on equipment.
Well, the market is going to be one problem.
I mean, guaranteed, you're not going to be able to touch the market.
It's almost no way.
You already can't do it on screen、world
transfer.、
So there are some people、that might be worried about what effect this might have on、data center and world economies.、there was the same worry、back when we, right before we started the world、visit system as well. But it turns out that the change,、the effect was、negligible. And、of course, we're going to be doing some simulations to make sure that that's the case here. But we don't feel that it will affect adversely、the economies.
さて、まあ大体これですね、ようやく終わりが見えたかな。
Alright, so I think that is pretty much all that we have today.
Give me something else.
Pretty much.
ちょっと待って。
Hold on.
なんか知ってる人の声する。
I think I've heard that voice before.
もう一つ何かですね、皆さんにお知らせしてないことがあるんじゃないの？
He's like the CEO or whatever.
Something important?ね、
重要なお知らせですよ、重要なお知らせ。
Something really important.
社長
It's the CEO.
はい、あれを表示して。
Do I on the screen?
よろしくお願いします。
え？何？ Ah, matta.
Okay.
Well, okay. That means we can drop PS4 now.
Open beta.
Drop PS4 support.
4月13日 から開始します。
That's kind of soon.
So the Final Fantasy 14 PlayStation 5 version open beta will begin on Tuesday, April 13th.
いや、ねえじゃないですよ。
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I'm confused. What's going on?
ね。いよいよ PS5 版のオープンベータが開始します。
Yes, the PlayStation 5 version open beta will begin soon.
これ次のパッチと同じ日なんでしょ
？And this is the same day as the next patch, right?
嘘でしょ
？No, you can't say that.
言ってなかったんだっけ？
言ってないですよ。パッチ 5.5 の日付は、まあ、
we haven't mentioned the release date for 5.5 yet. That was
ああ、そう。
ああ、そう。同じ日、right?
同じ日です。
So it's on the same day.
この日にやります。
まあ、
ちょっと、
ち
ょ
っと、一生懸命やってきた。
They leaked.
I mean, we've been working on it, yes, but...
それと、もう一つね。大事な、せっかくだから、ね、PS5 版の動画を持ってきたので、ぜひ皆さんに見てもらいましょうよ。
I actually brought some footage from this PlayStation 5 version.
はい、じゃあ流してください。お願いします。
Play the video.
How would you even be able to tell the difference?
I don't know. Interesting game.
Mimsa.
I don't see a difference because I want.
Can't see through the stream, you can't sell.
No, no, not、what、even that. This is fucking the same on PC.
How fast is load?
Load time!
Leave it.
Oh, that's really fast.
Looking for the mosquito in the fucking room.
Okay, I'd like to load.
Oh, and you even made a PowerPoint.
That's
pretty
amazing. Yeah, 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 yeah.
Isn't it like this already on the PS5 time there?
It is amazing, but...
it's definitely better than it was on the PS4, but...
Okay,
it's even faster with the new version, I won't complain.
Let's go and talk about it.
We'll have to wait for Tyler to load.
Yeah, probably.
The PlayStation 5 version will be featuring full 4K resolution support.
そしてね、今ちょっと動画の方でもご覧いただきましたが、あれまあ PS5 版そのものからキャプチャーしている映像になりますが、まあ、超高速ロード PS5 売りですね。さっきのあれ実測タイムなので、あのスピードでエリアチェンジできるようになります。
So the video, that you just saw, that was actual, PlayStation 5.Footage, and so you saw there the teleport and the quick loading time on the teleport. That is again one of the PlayStation 5's main selling points. That is the actual speed at which players will be able to teleport.
そしてですね、フレームレート、当然ですね、PS5 の、性能非常に
高くなって、
それを
生
かして
ですね、
フレームレート大幅向上させていただいてます。
This is a debit to Limsa on peak time.
Extremely powerful system, and that will help us significantly improve the frame rate for the PlayStation 5 version.
まあですので、今回、まあ、用途に分けてまたオプション設定増やしていこうと思うんですが、PS5 の場合は、もう 4K でとにかくグラフィックス至上主義で遊びたいよっていうモードと、
So, currently we're planning to have two different modes for the PlayStation 5 version. One mode being the 4K version, where those players that want to play Final Fantasy 14 at its most beautiful.
まあ 2K とか解像度を下げてもいいか、とにかくフレームレート爆速で、ど安定で遊びたいんだっていう人の、モードと、これ、まあ、リアルタイムにスイッチできるんで、切り替えて、お好みで遊んでいただければと思います。
And then a second mode that we have planned is our full HD 2K mode that focuses more on frame rate and optimizing that frame rate. And players will be able to go into config and change that in real time in the PlayStation 5 version.
PS4 版発売された時も覚えてらっしゃる方いらっしゃると思うんですが、パッチを当てるためにですね、 PS5 バージョンに PS5 ならではの特性を入れたアップデートっていうのも行っていく予定です。
And as we did when we first released our PlayStation Combat version, we plan on continuing to make improvements to the PlayStation 5 version over a series of patches.
はい、まあそんな感じです。
So yeah, that's about it.
で、お値段は？
And what's the price going to be?
The price?
これどうなの？
For the expansion?
For the expansion, yeah.
まあ、ちょっとじゃあ僕から社長に
How much is it usually?
Okay, so I have something to ask.
How much is the price usually?
僕としてはちょっとこうしたいっていうのがあるのでちょっと見ていただきたいです。
Okay, so this is what I want to do and I want you to take a look at this and see if it's okay.
Final Fantasy XIV の PS4 版のプレイ権をお持ちの方は、
If they could extend this to everything, that'd be cool. Because it's already pretty fucking dumb how you have to buy it on multiple like systems.
月額課金払ってくれてるならもうそのまま
PS5
で遊べちゃっていいんじゃないですか。
Currently there's an issue where like, you know, we play it on PC, right? If you play it on PlayStation, you'd have to also buy it for PlayStation.
Yeah, I knew that, okay.
Yeah, the licenses.
They're saying that it's not going to cost any money if you have PS4 version already.
But Tyler has the PS5, Tyler, do you have to buy the game again?
No, but they're saying for this upcoming new version.
Oh, okay.
と今 PS4 で遊んでる皆さんはそのまま PS5 でも遊べちゃい、まあ、簡単に言うとまあそういう風にしたいんですけど、どうですかね。
And I want players to be able to, those playing the PS4 version to be able to basically, you know, move over to that PlayStation 5 version without
like
having
boss.
To do anything.
ああ、それは
Can we make it free?
Yes, sounds like a good idea.
ね、皆さんのためですから。ぜひこれでいきましょう。
He says no.
Let's go with this.
社長太っ腹。
That's not what he said.
これもぜひ皆さんのためにぜひ。
Did you wanna go translate there, Eli?
よろしくお願いします。
Yes, so we are doing this for our players. Please look forward to the PlayStation 5 version.
社長持ち上げる声がすごいですよ。いや。これというわけで今私決済取れましたんで PS4 版のお持ちの方は追加のもう費用なく PS5 版にもうアップグレードしていただけるというふうに確約取れましたんでもうそれでいこうと思います。
So you heard it here, we got permission from the CEO himself. Those who have the PS4 version and that registered license will be able to upgrade
to the
PS5 version without any charge.
なので今 PS4 版の権利をお持ちの方はもう PS5 版の Final Fantasy XIV のパッケージも買っていただかなくて大丈夫です。
So those of you with that registered license and the PS4 version will not need to purchase the PlayStation 5 package.
ですのでもうなんとか本体だけ手に入れてください。
You won't need to buy the PlayStation 5 package, but you'll still need to try to find a PlayStation 5.
まあ、あの PS5 に、ね、合わせたグラフィックスのさらなる機能の追加とかっていうのは
今インハイの PS5
アップデートしていきますのでそちらも楽しみにお待ちいただければと思います。
And as we mentioned before, we plan to continue updates to the PlayStation 5 version, improving graphics, improving performance, with future patches.
ではですね、そんな太っ腹な、社長からですね、世界中の光の戦士の皆さんに一言ぜひね、ご挨拶を改めてお願いします。
So let's get a few words from our CEO before he leaves.
はい、改めまして、皆さんこんにちは。スクエアエニックスの松田です。
Square Enix.
Hello everyone. This is Yosuke Matsuda from Square Enix.
今日はファイナルファンタジー14新情報発表会ご視聴いただきありがとうございます。
Thank you very much for tuning in to Final Fantasy 14 announcement showcase.
ここまでいろいろなたくさんの情報ありましたが。
Kinda. I don't know. It's just like the perspective. Maybe. Yeah. It looks weird.
ぜひ最後まで楽しんでご覧ください。
Maybe his hands are normal, but he's a big head.
Today, including this PlayStation 5
I'm comparing to the size of the microphone.
Maybe it's a big microphone.
Please enjoy to the very end of this presentation.
そして Final Fantasy 14。 皆様のおかげで10年ここまでやってこれました。本当にありがとうございます。
And Final Fantasy XIV has managed to continue for 10 long years thanks to you, all the players around the world.
Dude, holy shit.
そして、吉田が先ほど言いましたように、彼はこれからも Final Fantasy XIV を聞いています。
You guys have been playing since the start, right?
そして、開発チーム一同、ゲームをもっともっと盛り上げていきますので、ぜひこれからも Final Fantasy XIV を
お願
いいたします。
I was like, I started like halfway through ARR patch cycle and then stopped for a bit and then came back and actually started to
make more progress in this game. So please look forward to it.
What about you, Shiny?
はい、スクエアニックス代表取締役社長の松田洋介でした。ありがとうございました。
What about you? What about you, Tyler?
I started right before Heaven's Word.
そうね、そのニュースマンっぽい。
発表されてね、しまいましたけど。
You over here, fucking baby. I started like 5.1, right?I don't know, I think it's not 5.1.
It was at launch, 5.1, 5.2. We were like fucking playing.
Yeah.
Play launch.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
まあ、オープンベータとかね、詳しい詳細またトピックスでお知らせして。
I think 5.2 because I remember.
You came in late to her because you didn't do all of the.
That's what I was to say. I think I started in late 5.2 because Nier Raid was current. The first Nier Raid was current. And first Eden was not current anymore.
It was still current, it just was about to be out.
Yeah.
ファンフェスで行っていこうと思います。
Alright, and so we're already over our time limit here, and
because I remember playing December full AR till to such a Stormblood, and then May 15 and 16. Boy. This is free too, right? Or this paid?
They're going to be showing it.
So our final announcement today is about the Final Fantasy Fan Festival 2001, our digital fan festival around the world.
Well, if it's a fan fest, it should be
on May 15th and 16th this year.
まあ、いつものファンフェス通り2日間丸14尽くしの、ファンフェスをやっていこうと思います。もちろん、音楽のステージも2日間しっかり用意してやっていこうと思ってます。
And just like all of our live Final Fantasy fan festivals, we plan to have 2 days full of content, including live concerts.
で、まあもちろんデジタルなので全世界に配信もしますし、まあ可能であればね、リアルで集まってもらえる方には来てもらうっていうのも考えたいですし、僕らもそこだけじゃなくてちょっとね、ゲームの中でもみたいな感じで丸2日間モニターとかゲームを通して
OT
を楽しめるファンフェスをやっていこうと思ってます。
September.
And while we're planning to have this fan festival again,
the expansion probably, yeah.
All players all around the world can attend. Possibly even players that are here in Japan might be able to attend in person. We'll see if that is allowed.
But
we want to have a full
2 days
filled with a Final Fantasy experience.
Not 3 months.
No, it was on the order of weeks.
An in-game type of event.
They said 3 months.
そしてですね。ライブストリームで世界中にと言いました。ですので、もうすべて音楽
コンテン
ツを今回はすべて無料で、視聴していただけるようにします。
And so, because we, again, it is going to be online, we want to tell everyone that this stream
is
in its entirety, including the concert, will be free.
まあもちろんだから、まあプライマルズのライブとかあるのかな。まあそういった音楽ステージとかも、ストリーム無料でお届けしていこうと思ってます。
So a lot of people out there are thinking there'll be, for example, a Primals concert. If there is, it will be streamed live for free.
Wait, it's going to be free of charge?
Yes, dude.
I
just came back.
Surprise. アーカイブからは映像がね残らないようにするかもしれないので、ぜひですねリアルタイムに視聴していただけると大変助かります。
Just one thing though about the live performances, because it does involve people that are not affiliated with Square Enix, there is a chance that after the stream, while the stream is free, after the stream, it might be archived. So make sure
the archive is in real time. Makes sense.
なんかコメントでですね、太っ腹すぎて心配なんだよなって。
They're worried that we're giving too much.
あれ払ってもいいんだぞって書いてくださってる方が。
People are even saying that, oh, we're willing to pay.
そういった方はですね、ぜひこのファンフェス記念アイテムを購入していただけると助かります。
So those of you who are willing to pay, we have something for you to pay for if you like.
Dude, that mount.
今回前回ね、クラウドのフェンリルというバイク、
That's a nice whale. That's a nice whale.
Hey, my whale is a nice boy. My whale is a nice boy.
So as you remember, with our
last
fanfest, we had Cloud's bike Fenrir. For this digital fan festival, we're planning to have this mount, the Lunar Whale.
まあ、アマロ先生のね、昔のデザインをちょっと再現しております。
Actually, used Yoshitaka Amano's original artwork as a base for this design.
35.
ちょっとこちらですね。一応完成しているので動画をお持ちしました。
Actually, this is already been completed, and so we have a video to show you. Take a look at it.
It's going to be 35, probably.
Probably. That beat is really nice, though. And it's probably going to be limited edition, too. Is this the mount?
They were in Cursus right there.
Wait, what's this? The mount?
Okay, that's now they're just going all over the place.
That's really fucking nice, dude. So it is smaller, blah, blah, blah. It is smaller than the whale you have.
I'm not showing it in action. Come on.
What? Excuse me?
Seven feet?
Alright,
you're welcome.
I'm
buying
this
for
$35.
Oh my god.
You need to do math with
it. No, it's not a 7-seater, it's an 8-seater. Those were the additional 7
Oh, fuck.
It's those were the full party. Why would they make a 7-seater, not an 8-seater?
Shut up, I'm excited.
いかがだったでしょうか。ファイナルファン
タジー
初
の
一人乗
りマウント。
50 probably. I'm counting on 50.
This is Final Fantasy first ever
8-person. Dude, that's world.
さらにですね、このファンフェス記念してもう一種アイテムがございます。
We also have one more item available. Actually, three.
まあ今回ね、行月のフィナーレエンドウォーカーが月に絡んでいるということで、ファイナルファンタジー4のオマージュエッセンスっていうのも。いろいろ期待できるかなと思うんですが、その方からミニオンとしてエッジ、ローザ、ユリアのミニオンがファンフェス記念として発売となります。
And because a big part of the Endwalker story focuses on the moon, we decided to go the route of Final Fantasy IV, which also took place somewhat on the moon, and to take characters from there and create minions from them. We have Edge, Rosa, and
fucking Ace to see them.
どちらもね、
Can do fucking maps in one mount. That's fucking cool.
5月15日から販売スタートの予定です。どうぞよろしくお願いします。
We plan to have them available for purchase on the same day, that first day of the Final Fantasy Fan Festival on May 15th.
So you can start selling my kidney.
はい。ファンフェスの情報もね、今日この後の PLL とかでまたちょっと触れていこうと思ってます。
Regarding the Fan Festival, we have a little bit more information to give you, and we plan on doing that in the letter from the producer live that is coming up after this showcase. Four more minutes.
さて、すいません、ちょっと時間オーバーしてしまいましたが、これで今日お伝えできる内容は全て出し切りました。
And with that, we are way
Wait,
over our time.
What are we going to show on the
light
later?
We're finally finished.
We're
going to
show
the showcase.
You actually think we're going to show the 0.5 patch stuff?
Yeah, it's okay.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, 皆さんも本当にありがとうございます。
Very much.
それではですね、ハイデリンゾディアーク編のその衝撃のラスト、ぜひそれをですね、震えてお待ちいただけたらと思います。
With Endwalker, we're finally approaching the climax of the story of Heidlin and Zodiark. So, please look forward to it.
New trailer?
Ooh,
oh, all artwork. That's right? Really nice.
Heidlin and Zodiark. I think.
Yeah.
Please look forward to it.
もう最後にちょっとね、これ補足ですが、天野義孝先生に書いていただいた今回のエンドウォーカーのイメージイラスト。
And so this is actually the last thing that we have. Here's some artwork that we had especially created for us by the master Yoshitaka Amano.
まあどちらが善でもどちらが悪でもないと 天地、逆にもできるようなデザインでぜひお願いしますというので、結構無茶な僕ね、注文、天野先生にお願いしたんですけど。
So we went to, 天野先生 to ask him to create this for us. We told him that we wanted something that was, whether you looked at it from the top or the bottom, it would be, you could have a different sort of image, that there is no good, there is no bad, there is no dark, there is no light. And, I think he did a really good job.
まあぜひですね、このアートにも仕掛けいろいろあります。ストーリー、クリアした時に見るとまたちょっと印象変わるのかなとも思いますので、ぜひこれらも含めて全力でこれから、進めていこうと思いますので、どうぞ楽しみにお待ちください。
In this, illustration, there's a lot of, stuff hidden about the story. You could take a look at it now and speculate. We also would like you to maybe take another look
at it. That's the planet and the moon.
And you'll,
yes.
It'll take on
a Zodiac's hand is on the moon part.
So, we really enjoy the art and hope you do too.
改めまして、全世界の光の戦士の皆さん、本当に長い時間最後までご視聴ありがとうございました。
Right, to all of our warriors of light watching us from around the world, thank you for staying
with
us for so long. Thanks,
Yoshi-P-sama.
ただしこの後、日本時間午後3時から今度はプロデュースされたライブがございますので、そちらでまた後ほどお会いしましょう。
But we're not done yet because in just a couple hours at 3 o'clock Japan Standard Time, we have
the letter from the producer live.
We'll talk all about 5.5.
はい、ありがとうございました。
At 3 Japan...
Yeah, so in 2 hours and a half.
So, 2 hours, 2 hours.
That was really nice. That was really fucking nice. Okay, I'm gonna end the stream. Actually, first of all.
See you in 2.5 hours, bitches.
No, you're not gonna see me. That's way too late for me. Thanks for joining, boys. We didn't make a bingo, but that's not the point of
it. No, there wasn't.
No, take my stream.I'm pretty sure we didn't make a bingo.
Right, it's not Forspoken, difficult format content. Yeah, that doesn't count.
There's no difficult dungeon.
They say challenging new dungeons, that's just, it's not because they're actually hard. They're... Not the name, no hey, ultimate, no Eggy Slammer, we're going to Sharlan. Like I said, the raid is probably Marisidia.
Yeah, but we didn't, like, actually...
Yeah, they didn't say it, but I'm pretty sure it's fucking Marisidia.
New Ultimate Reveal is gonna be shown on fucking 5.5, but that's, like, fucked.
Guest game developer... Well, there's not gonna be a guest game developer, they just...
Yeah.
Effectively said as much, I think. Unless, Prominence... Sorry, not Prominence, Pandemonium has some kind of guest on it.F. New NPC revealed almost.
Yeah.
We're so close.
Then female Hrulgar. But.
That's not.
That's why it's in a fucking corner over there.
New limited job. They're probably gonna show the new limited job in May.
They're gonna show off Reaper in May. Yeah.
That's not limited job, stupid. That's a big beast master.
Or they knew what they did with
the limited.
Show it. The life letter, drop it.
In the life letter? You think there's no way.
They did that with Blue Mage.
Wait, did they?
Yeah.
With a limited job.
Yeah, that's what I'm
saying. Oh, okay, yeah.
No. They're not doing it mid patch. Again, not with the big gen.
Oh, but you're saying they showed the class, they didn't like launch it? Is that what you were trying to say?
They showed the class and the next patch they launched it.
Okay.
So I think it was like 5.4 later, they showed it and then no, it was like 4.4, I think. They dropped it to the next patch.
Pepe hands. Yeah, because they didn't even show the new 24-man raid name. The female Hrulgar was like really hard, and then the new NPC was that was super fucking close. And then the male Viera, that was also another one that was hard. Pepe saw. Okay, I'm gonna end the stream. Thanks for joining, boys. Bye, see you guys later.
Babe.
Okay. where's the chat? Okay, guys, I'm on the stream. I'll see you guys tomorrow. Thanks for watching. We had a lot of really good news. I'm not gonna stream the live later because it's gonna be 3 a.m. for me, so we're gonna have to skip that one. So I'll see you guys tomorrow. And we can talk about it too. So yeah, bye bye.